I'm gonna go ahead and go live. The good news is that...
That's 14.
Yeah, I did see that. I wonder if he's an attack pack one, though.
Alright, well, I guess we'll see. Alright. Are you live?
Yeah, I am.
I have 301. Ready for takeoff? And launch.
Nice, I got you synced up this time. Town 310 launching Cat 2 outcom. 310
is airborne. 301 airborne, headed to Angels 35.
I'm gonna keep my eye on my RWR though, and see if I got any other spikes. Because for you, that unit doesn't, and then it's not attack back. Yeah, that little delay actually worked out. It's like magic hour now.
Nice.
Shoot, oh, my camera is not working, I guess.
Ascending to 35,000, about 9,000 feet right now, headed to 353, sorry.
And Tom Pat is still on the ground. It looks like the other guy just came like Sonora.
Alright.
Yeah, probably about a mile off your, about 4 o'clock low, 4 or 5 o'clock low. About 100 miles.
Yeah, not too bad.
If they don't have tag pack, we're already out of range of their labels. So we're about 47 miles. Looks like you need to start your contrail and you're right around the mile. Is that Angels 24?
Yeah, Angels 26 actually.
I just started contrail myself. Should be able to see mine.
Yeah, I see you.
Oh, do you mind going back to probably like the first stage burners, or like right when they're first lit?
I want
to get the best fuel efficiency. At least as far as range goes. In the Super Hornet, believe it or not, first stage burners is actually more fuel efficient than mill power at altitude. I should be able to catch you here in a minute.
I copy. Leveling off now, 35,000.
Yeah.
It looks like we're about 90 miles out. Where I am, at least.
Yeah. I'm 5. Place 85 from the tip of the island. That's where I put one of the waypoints in the map.
A lot of turbulence.
It's porpoising a lot. It will do that, though.
Oh yeah, I was having trouble keeping my level up.
There we go, spike sink.
Yep.
I'm gonna go ahead and get my arm ready. I'm gonna go out next hot as well for a second.
Alright, I got my numbers.
Yeah, same. I'm gonna go back to Nose Cole now that I know where he is.
Do you throw your decoy on?
No, I do not. I'm always scared I'm gonna forget to turn it off. Superbug's gonna track me. In arm range. I'm gonna make my way to that line of rest with you. About 64 miles out. I'll probably pop a couple at him.
Would you need your laser to drop the bombs?
Yeah, for these laser guided bombs that I got coming up. Spike, so that makes me already think he probably doesn't have attack back.
Nah, he's just trying to catch up with us and inspect them. See what we're doing. Looks like we're about 40 miles out. Target disappeared.
310 against the target. Are you sure your target's shaking?
What was that?
Just my arms. I'm calling out that most likely my arms just destroyed the radar sights.
Yes.
It'll search for anything remaining in that area if there is anything. I'll ease it out. You're clear to fire whenever you want.
301 mag.
Nice. That looks cool. So 80 seconds before my bombs are released.
My target didn't carry over.
As long as you got their numbers plugged in, you should be able to waypoint designate them again.
I've got no one talking.
Bruh. I'm live, by the way. It's 45 seconds. Down there on my clear pod, see if I can see the spot anything blows up.
No, I mean, I got something on my ground radar about 25 miles out.
Yep, okay, I see. 310, ground target's destroyed. You're barely seen through the clouds. Still got 2 500-pound laser drive bombs service put. I Unless they want to do the other two on the control tower or something.
I have. I'm pulling up to a target. I'm about 15 miles away. Yeah, I don't know what it it locked onto, but I have 15 seconds to release.
Yeah. All right. Might join in on that though. Hopefully, our bombs will have the same.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and release.
310 bombs gone.
301 bombs gone. Let's see what it's going.
I just said a general area, 2,400 pound bombs. We're on the same trajectory. But I'm a Winchester this time. That just means I'm out of air ground munitions other than my guns.
Copy. Did you start heading towards the ship?
No, I tried to go inverted on you. But I'm too heavy and it's too high.
I see it. I still have my 82s to drop.
Turn around and investigate that Tomcat.
Yeah, let's go for it. I'll hit that target on the way back and drop my AQs.
We are still ascending, it looks like, so it's, yeah, I don't know if
we're... Oh, jeez, I didn't realize.
No, you're good.
My bolt turned off.
I don't know if a barometric hold, though, will hold very well at this altitude. Usually it only works around, 36 or lower.
Alright, I'm gonna descend. I'll descend back to Angels 35.
No worries.
And I'm breaking left.
Yeah.
Turning around to the position.
Oh, my bad. I'm on nose hot still. There we go.
No worries. Give me that virtual cancer.
VirtualCancer.com.
There's 35.
I'm leveling off. I'm gonna go nose hot and see if I can pick up on this guy. I'm at about 329 knots. If that helps you out.
I'm good, yeah. Actually flying a lot of right echelon today.
I think it's easier like to fly an echelon with your dominant eye, if that makes any sense.
I had to do both quite a bit. Like being a slot pilot, you always have to fill in for a week. So ideally, you should be a proficient mode. I'm not sure, because I started flying off the right side when I first started practicing formation. I found left side to be hard, so then I only started doing left for a while. I guess like forcing myself. Now that's probably actually one of my stronger sides. Even though I shouldn't really have a stronger side. We got a lot of light caressing again. Check my radar.
I got nothing. I'm running nose hot right now. I'm gonna dump these MK-82s. I got nothing. Just you. That looks like we're about 140 miles away from the airport. So, maybe they're over there.
I got a 737 over here at the airport, looks like. Tomcat, though, actually looks about off to the right, maybe. About 45 degrees. Probably about heading 210-ish.
Alright. I guess let's turn right and hit 210.
I still got 10,000 pounds of gas.
I'm full up 13.6, so I'm good.
The Tomcats will burn a lot of gas trying to chase after them, I guess.
I
one thing that will help your autopilot a lot is when you do get to your altitude, pull it up to like so the velocity vectors on the horizon and engage barometric hold. And that'll get rid of a lot of the porpoising, please.
I got somebody about 75 miles away, 30,000.
That's probably our Tomcat right there.
Yep.
Yep. I see him. Yep. Angel's 30.6 miles.
Get my tinfoil hat.
450 knots closure.
Are you running burners?
No, I'm still with you. But, like just first thing with burners.
All right, I'm lining up with him. About 245 degrees. Descending 30.
I'm still with you. My nose still pointing.
I see you behind me.
My bad. It's hot too. It's cold.
Off at Angel's 30,000. I have my heading set at 245. I'm just gonna ride it out, see what this guy's doing. He's in full burners.
Are you seeing him friendly?
No, I'm not picking him up friendly, are you?
Yeah, I'm gonna put a lead on him a little bit for intercept course. I'm gonna take about 270.
Are you still team 4?
I am, or I'm still team 3. But it might just be because I was really close to you.
Yeah, I switched to team 3, I'm not picking up friendly.
Yeah, I think it's just because I'm gonna reset my radar. I think it's just because my jet was picking up your transponder, so it will do that sometimes.
Alright.
Although, I don't know if I'm ever going to be able to catch this guy. Yeah, he is a 0.5 Mach, but it's a long shot. I'm going to gain a little bit of altitude, though, so I can get a little bit of airspeed advantage on him.
Alright, I'm gonna try to position. Maybe if we shoot in front of him, we might be able to close the distance.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. I'm putting a little bit of lead on him. Right now, I'm up at Angel's 35 again, so I can also get a little bit more airspeed advantage on him, or like closure rate.
Alright, I'm gonna run burners. I got some fuel, so
I'm 8.6, so I'm 90 miles away from the ship, so I'm kind of cautious with that, just because, they chasing these things down, going away from us, will run us dry really fast, especially the burners.
I'm catching up to them. I think I'll be all right.
Yeah, I'm showing 370, and I have first stage burners, but I'm not going to run like full burners or anything. I'm going to still try to remain pretty fuel efficient.
All right, I'm about 420. Gaining on them. I got him at 32,000.
Yeah, looks like it's coming up a little bit. He turns back towards us. Yeah, it would make the intercept a lot easier. I'm at 30 miles.
Gordon Spamsy.
I'm slowing down again. I got about 0.4 now.
Yeah, I'm catching up to him. About 18 miles out.
Inland ice floating.
Oh, he's diving.
Yep. He's still slow, though. He's turning back into us.
Uh-oh. All right.
Well, I don't know. I'm not getting a spike, though, yet from him. Oh, it does look like...
No, he's... I think he's just trying to see what we're doing.
I'm out of descending to him. I lost him on radar.
I have visual on him.
I got him.
I'm about 5 miles from him.
Ah, nice.
I lost him. Clouds and shit.
He might be descending out of this island that's underneath us. Oh, okay, I got him. 0.9 Mach 817. Unless that's you.
That's me.
Oh, okay.
I see you. Yeah. He might have dove. He might be low. He might have lost some terrain.
Looking for any airport around here. Maybe if we landed there. He's on approach or something. I'm scanning with my radar now.
I'm not picking up anything on the ground.
I see you. Yeah, I'm bringing my nose. Oh, okay. I see him. Angel's 8.6 miles, 5 miles from me. It's a Tomcat. No way.
What happened?
That's an Aerosoft Tomcat.
Are you picking him up on radar or visual?
I'm visual. It's Iranian Air Force Tomcat.
I got him. I see you right behind him, catching him about 12 miles out.
7.4 fuel. I have no idea. I haven't seen a spike from him, but then again, most people would fly the Aerosoft 1R TAC pack. He might just not have his radar on. But he hasn't shot at us, so.
Oh, pull up on him.
Yeah, I'm coming over to him right now.
I see.
He's at 0.6 miles.
About 9 miles from you, 9.5 from him. Turning around, looks like.
Yeah, he's in a left turn right now, 340 knots. Yeah, that's a Aerosoft Tomcat. I can't believe it. I mean, it still doesn't necessarily mean he has TAC back, you know, like I put it. It's just that I don't know if anyone who would buy the Aerosoft Tomcat that doesn't have it. Oh, just had to pause for a second there. Glitch, probably.
I have visual on him. I'm pulling up on his right.
Yeah, I don't know if you you have that one. It's a gray and or not gray, but brown textures. The Iranian Air Force ones. So,
no, I never downloaded
still
it.
Flying.
Actually, what was the one that you told me to download?
Yeah, that's this is the one right here. It's actually, I hold a lot of respect for people who fly it, like, just because it's actually truly difficult to fly. It's nothing like Dino's. It's a whole different league.
Definitely different. Pulling up right next to you.
Yeah. I'm glad I came over here for the intercept. You know, historically, we typically shoot at the Iranian Air Force Tomcats, but this guy doesn't seem hostile or anything. I don't even feel like testing if he has TAC back or anything. This guy's chill as heck.
Dead?
Nope. I just saw his stabilators move.
He might have just noticed us.
Showing 140 miles from the ship, 6.7 fuel. How are you looking?
7.3.
Yeah, we probably got to start heading back pretty soon. At least a tanker or something.
All right, yeah, we can start heading back. Break off.
Right, I'm gonna switch back to nav mode. Yeah, I'm showing. I got enough gas to make it back, but yeah, I might as well play it safe in case something turns hostile. You said you're already broken off, or? Oh, I see you back there.
I was waiting for you to break off.
Oh, yeah. I'll go ahead and start heading back myself. I'm just gonna go on a couple attack again. I never saw him flare or anything, so actually he probably doesn't have TAC pack. I also didn't see any weapons on him. Doesn't mean his gun isn't loaded though.
He might just not know how to use it. Or he's friendly.
Just minimum stage burners. I'm just planning on going up to about angels 33 probably, because I gotta head back east. And,
I got visual on you.
Yeah.
Shut that small mouth.
Bruh.
Doc, you should your next stream wear an N95 mask.
Are you getting that DSL modem, Joe?
What's up?
That DSL modem.
What DSL modem?
The dick sucking lip modem.
The what?
Just talking smack back.
Are we watching smack back?
Yeah, I'm still streaming. I don't think I got any viewers right now, but it's recording it too, so I'll just put it on YouTube.
Dude, this is like the worst stream I ever saw in my life.
Yeah. Suck a fat one.
Suck it.
I wonder if he said anything in chat. Oh, I think it was Flyboy.
What did he say?
Hello, Bob. Or, hi, Bob. It will de-sync like that sometimes. Yeah, they're actually tucked away, but sometimes it shows another player with them, up.
Oh, okay.
I told him he was live. He'd be able to see us. Oh, okay, so he's the 737. It wasn't Flyboy, it was someone else. Probably Battle Koala or something like that. Let me see if this tells me. No, it's a Flyboy. Huh. Oh, okay. Apparently he was in a 737 that got substituted.
Nice.
That was cool though, we got the intercept tank back.
I think I know what skin that was. I think I have that. It's like a basic skin.
I'm actually going to make a slight right turn to about 1-2-3-ish degrees.
Roger.
Right. The reason for that is the ship is heading north and we're heading east, you know, so I want to get behind the ship, you know, before I commence, you know, for the base of recovery, if that makes sense. I'm trying to set us up for success.
Roger. I'm at 4.6 right now.
I'm 6.2. Actually, you're going to burn less gas simply as lead because you're going to be making fewer power adjustments. You want to go ahead and take a lead, just plug in 1-2-3 degrees for your heading select. And you can probably go barometric hold already right now. You'll be fine as long as you stay in first stage burners.
All right, Roger.
I'll fly off of you. Yeah, typically, like if someone's low on gas, I want them to fly lead just because they're gonna stick their throttle at the efficient power setting, you know, and leave it there, and therefore they burn less gas typically. But you'll actually notice, are you in nav mode right now? Like out of air to air or air to ground mode?
I'm in air to air.
If you go to nav mode, and all you can do, or the way you get that is just unclick air to air, so neither one of those things are lit up. If you look at your HSI, you see where it says TACAN or the TCN, and then you got a bunch of numbers to the right of it.
You're talking about my my fuel, how much fuel when I get there?
Oh, what's that?
It's like the FPS, basically.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, on your HSI, it also has that by it actually has a number right below CV, and that's how many thousands of pounds of gas you'll have when you get to whatever you're targeting or whatever you're looking at.
Bingo.
And you'll actually notice you'll actually have more gas to spare if you go to first stage burners versus staying in the middle.
Oh yeah, you're right. All right, cool. Went up to 3,500 when I reached. So.
Yeah, the jet has the most range when it's at first stage burner up here at this altitude. Like at pretty much 25,000 or above, it's actually most fuel efficient at first stage.
All right, I level up at 32,000.
I'm not coming over to you. What's up?
How was your week?
Huh?
How was your week?
Oh, fantastic. Is that a vacation?
I didn't ask for a whole statement, so shut up now.
All right, thanks. Christ. Jersey Shore jerk off.
Jersey Shore jerk off. That could be a tag name. The Corona Virus. That's what Trump does. The virus. Bruh.
Everyone's trying to blame someone for it. It's a freaking virus. Like, it doesn't. There's no human being responsible.
Yeah, someone's responsible. They didn't need to eat fucking bats.
Well, maybe I have a little bit of a point there, but.
Hey, I'll be right back.
Yeah.
We don't need to eat fucking bats.
Target ships by chance on your radar?
Yeah, I know how to do it.
That's always useful to know. Extra lightweight when we get back to the ship.
Yo, is that you? Headed for the ship?
What?
I
didn't know FSX was on the map to play on the map.
Oh.
He's on his OSX.
Why am I picking up a friendly 65 miles away?
Oh, that's the tanker.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, if we
I'm gonna go eat. Fuck you.
Right, we're missing it. that's actually pretty cool, dude. It's been about an hour long sort, not including our first attempt.
Gotta thank the government for closing everything down.
Yeah, it's like our summer break, I guess, for adults.
Except you can't do anything.
Yeah. It's funny, I still got your clear pod pointed off to the port. Might be, I'm still looking at that CM site. Not that there's anything, that's totally normal. It's just
yeah, it's
that level
on,
of detail.
It's on
the target. Mine's pointed over there as well. It's on 45 miles. Down 310 holding hands with 301 inbound mothers, Angels 32 bearing 270. Inbound to land, peace from USS Ronald Reagan.
Actually,
Ray might start to ascend if you wanted to here and pull back your power. You'll probably get there with over 2,000 pounds. 2.2 is where you're supposed to clear a fuel emergency. So that's where you get the fuel low mass caution. You're out of yet to declare an emergency, but yeah, that is where they have. You'll get the mass caution.
Alright, I guess the real one for start my descent.
Yeah. Now granted, it's we still got probably about 30 more miles or so, or maybe about 20 miles before we get really half to the ship. You might want to pull out your power though now, just been, like, probably go to like half power or so. Just because, now that you're descending, you're going to be hitting that lower altitude, and burners will suck up a lot of gas down there. You won't make it back to ship low altitude for safe burners. Since you're going in first, I'll go ahead and go over to right echelon.
I copy.
Visual of the ship over there. Man, that was all over the place on that. That was a terrible technical call. What are you doing, Doc? Get stable. My bad, I was acting like a buffoon back there.
It's all good.
You see the ship over there to your left? It's about 10 o'clock.
I don't have visual on it yet. I'm gonna descend. Try to get down to about 4,000 feet.
Yeah, it's going north. So it's too much further. We'll be well behind it. I started turn maybe about 060-ish. I'll put you close to where you need to be. Obviously, your final bearing is probably going to be about 350-ish or so. Talent 310 all against 301 platform, state 411. Typically, I'll hold on to about 1200 feet once I get there, and then I just fly straight in.
I copy.
Probably make a turn straight onto the ship now. You should be lined up pretty well aft of it. Probably going to be looking at about north or 355-ish.
All right, copy.
Nice. Right, 1200 for a little below, but you should have a pretty good lineup there. I'll see you on deck. I'm gonna flip a bitch real quick, give some space, and I'll be in right behind you.
All right, copy.
310 is commencing stake 411. I'll usually wait until I'm like 5 miles out before I pop my my gear flaps and everything.
Yeah, 301, I'm about 9 miles out. I have visual on the ship.
Nice. Well, 310 is 10 miles, needles, on centerline fly up.
001, 5 miles out.
Last 7 miles, 2 miles behind ya. Is 5 miles down and dirty.
Three zero one, 3 miles.
Right around the 3 mile mark, that's where you're going to be on the glide slope. Start descending if you were at 1200 feet.
Copy, I'm,
Oh, I see you. You got a good lineup.
Ow. 301, 1 mile out.
Yeah. Alright, a little bit right for lineup.
Yeah.
Tiny bit more power. Looking good though. Hey.
Looks like you made one wire. One wire.
Not bad. Telling 310 is 1.5 miles. Mongolites up on center line, super ornate ball, 3.7, man.
Green deck.
Yeah.
It's green deck, good to go.
Roger that. Not leading it enough, I'm a little bit high, a little bit to the left. High there in the end, I had to pull a lot of power. I was riding fast on my AOA. But hey, that was a successful strike. And we'll still call it a Tomcat intercept. It was the same for us. Yeah, that was a good strike. I think I'm gonna call it a stream though for here or for now. But yeah, I hope everyone has a good rest of your weekend. I will be back up tomorrow for the usual Saturday stream. But as always, happy flying till next time.